this particular show, The Seven Deadly Fascinations, the work was accomplished in a, I would say the period from December 2012. I was thinking about the show that I had to have in April. And then late December, January, I came upon some paintings, classical paintings, paintings done maybe in the 15th century, 16th century, which artists often did. They would do a painting about the seven deadly sins. They would paint, you know, a guy sleeping on the table, and that would be sloth, or someone just feeding their face, and that would be gluttony. And along with religious paintings, it was a, you know, a teaching type of painting. People knew, everybody knew what the seven deadly sins were. So I was like, man, I need to come up with something for my show. And I'm like, huh, maybe I could do my own spin on the seven deadly sins. We certainly are still fascinated with them. And then I'm saying, well, the word sin is sort of in fascination. And you go to a store and you look on the tabloids and it's all about people falling because of falling into their lust, or look at how fat she's gotten, or he's just love, or someone stole that because they wanted it, what, you know? And not only are people still prone to taking themselves down through the seven deadly sins, but we are also fascinated with people getting brought down by the seven deadly sins. So I used a bunch of my glamour magazines that I collect and popular culture magazines, and I just started making some collages. And so my paintings, all the paintings in this particular exhibit, all of them started out as very small collages, cutting paper up and laying it down and working out all my composition that way. Now, I didn't know this, but somewhere down the line, and I'm talking hundreds of years ago, somebody associated animals with the seven deadly sins. So they associated, let's see here, a goat with lust, a snail with sloth, it's pretty obvious, a pig with gluttony, a snake with envy, a peacock with pride, a toad with greed, and a lion with anger. Some years ago, I had done a series of paintings with people with different, their heads were changed around and they were birds, and people with a purse on their head and a carousel horse on their head. And I don't have any more idea than you do why these ideas come. I just make the association, going back into the collective unconsciousness, that surrealistic mindset that just makes an instant association between two disparate images, but they look right together, and I don't think anything more than that, and I just smack them together, and it looks right to me, and it has a harmony, and I just go with it. So that gave me another in of like, okay, I'll associate these animals with these traits and see what happens. And lo and behold, I actually came up with, I made seven collages, and then just one by one started executing the paintings, all the same size, at the scale of 4 feet by 6 feet, and basically painted them all from late January to the end of March, and then rounded out my show with three other paintings that had been done at the very beginning of that period that were also collage based on collages.